está bien.
No, no.
¿Por qué está haciendo esto?
Tiene reflujo gástrico.
Yeah, I mean, my first discovery of Ultraman came through a Japanese manga called Dr. Slump. I was around 4 or 5 where I found, I think it was my cousin's manga in a house at my grandparents, and just like found this character in that comic where she was fascinated with Ultraman. And then next thing I know, I'm watching Ultraman with my older brother, fighting over who gets to be which Ultraman. So that was my first introduction in Japan.
And for me, it was, I obviously didn't grow up in Japan. I grew up in rural Kentucky, but they played Ultraman on the weekends. And I remember the first time I watched it and how different that character was from the Marvel or DC Comics heroes that I'd grown up seeing. This giant red and silver man who fights these huge monsters. So it really made an impression on me that I carry with me through life, and I've remained a huge fan since then. I would like to say this movie's for everybody. You don't need to be an Ultraman fan. You just need to want to have fun. Come expecting to feel something, and if you watch it and love it, tell as many people about it as you can, because it's for everybody.
Yeah, and there's plenty of Easter eggs in there, so if you're a fan, you'll recognize them.
Yeah. So, you know, when you have a kid, they don't come with instructions. You just have to talk to other experienced people. So I called my mom and dad, and I wanted to express some of that, like, absolute terror and having a baby in the home, and like take those elements of, like, with my daughter, when she cry, it feels like it's gonna shatter your ears. Weaponize those things in our movie, because we can, you can push those fantasy elements, but they're all rooted in that experience. Or the joys, when you start to see yourself in your child for the first time. We've got that scene when Emmy starts to mimic Ken swinging the bat. And I remember those moments with my own daughter when I would see her making expressions that I could see myself in, or I could see my wife in. Those are those magic moments, and just trying to fold all those things into the film.
Yeah, I connect with Ken Sato because, you know, I was born in Japan, and I came to the States when I was 8. And so, you know, being Japanese American and having that cultural, you know, challenge growing up, you start to like figure out that, like, maybe, you know, you want them to not see you, you know, your skin color or where you come from. And so I really dove into drawing and doing art, and that's where, like, people will recognize who I am, but through the art first. And I think my older brother did the same through playing baseball. And so that's my sort of connection, where you start to, you know, use your own skills or talent or something to kind of get everyone's eyes off of you. So there's that side of Ken as a character. And then once you, you know, come to your native country, and then you're still seen as an outsider because you have such an American persona. So you just have to, like, kind of go with that and just say, like, you know, maybe I'm not so Japanese, but you know, just through this journey of, like, working on this film and really looking at myself, and it does have that, like, deeper connection and how I have to, like, see myself and portray myself moving forward. And you know, and I say I'm just, you know, proud of what we've done and who I am as a Japanese American. And so, yeah.